What grade are you in?
Two.
What's your favorite subject in class?
Maths.
Wow, that's a smart kid.
Meet Melaiah Chicki, a 7-year-old with a beautiful heart. She attends June Valley Primary School and is in grade 2, a student of Rupa Maino. In a conversation with Mr. Maino's daughter, who attends the same school but a grade higher, she learned of what her teacher was going through.
His mother and father used to come angry to the house, and in the morning, he don't eat when he comes to school. He used to just come to us and teach us.
And what she did next goes to show how much teachers mean to students.
As soon as the mother came up with the plastic shopping, I can see the joy in Melaiah. She hugged me, she hugged the mother for a very long time. And we took her to the school, and we asked her if she's okay carrying the plastic to the teacher. And she said, yes, I am okay carrying the plastic. So she got the plastic, and I told the mother to escort her to class, and that's how she went, and she gave the packet of rice plus tin fish and noodles to the teacher. And then from there, my wife actually saw that the teacher was actually saving without telling anyone that is about the problems he's going through.
Mr. Maino is a committed father to 7 children and a teacher to 60 students, all the while struggling to survive each day.
He is walking to school on empty stomach with the daughter, who is in grade 3, and they are struggling. And to me, is that without a complaint, that the teacher is serving with dignity. I give credit to Mr. Maino for being a very true Papua New Guinean and a true Melanesian.
The Education Department and the Teaching Service Commission explains that the change in the pay packet is due to the conclusion of the 3% pay increment for the teachers dating back to 2017. This increment is the first of the 3 salary adjustments which the government had agreed to pay the teachers between 2017 and 2019. The TSC chairman, Baran Sori, reportedly said all teachers returned to their normal salary on May 20, 2018. Teachers Association President Ugwalubu Mwana, however, says pay cuts in teachers' pay packets is not a new issue. It's one that has existed over many years, and he blames this partly on the Alaska payroll system. He says the number of teachers affected this year has increased over the last 6 pay days, and authorities should now come clear.
Year in, year out, we had complaints on unnecessary deductions on teachers' pay. Not just this year, because this year a lot of teachers got affected in one fortnight, but it has been a long-standing issue with the payroll system and the teachers' disbursement of teachers' salaries and entitlements. That is why for myself as General Secretary and Association, we maintain that the Alaska payroll should be taken away from that management of teachers' payroll. A new payroll system should be introduced to cater for the large workforce like the teaching service.
Cordial dialogue has been established between the Education Department, Teaching Service Commission, and the PNG Teachers Association. But to date, action still lacks. Teachers, the largest and increasing workforce in the country, are still left with unanswered questions and decreasing pay packets.
It's common sense for everybody to know that times are hard, and for teachers to continue to see random deductions on their pay is pretty unbearable. And it's absurd, it's intolerable, it's frustrating, and I would think very much that the Department of Education as well as the Teaching Service Commission take up the case by case and investigate. Interview the teachers who are affected. Interview them and establish whether they really got the loans. Interview them whether they, tell them why they're getting the money out of their pay as recovery. Recovery for what?
In other organizations, you will see in other departments, actually in other departments, you'll see like they're highly paid. And even the security guards around in NCD, they're also leveling up our with our salaries nowadays, you will see. And I think and I see that we should be mostly looked at properly.
You know, teachers are the backbone of this country. And if we are not caring for them, how can they survive while teaching our children? And some of us are okay, but when you look at teachers, what if they say, no, we won't teach for the next 2 weeks? That will be a big problem for the country.
It may take a long while before the teachers get the proper recognition they deserve, but to children like 7-year-old Melaiah, Mr. Maino and other teachers will always be their heroes.
As I am living now, that's all my focus I have, is the children that I must teach. Because I know when I teach them, there are little blessings that come to them.
Thank you, Mr. Maino.